I'm Rachel Vasca with Bossier Parish Community College, the Division of Science, Nursing, and Allied Health. Today I'm going to talk to you about vanquishing vocabulary. As you study in anatomy and physiology, you will notice that even the smallest structures can have the biggest of names. We, in science lecture, will introduce as many as 50 new terms in a single lecture. So you will see that if you can understand your vocabulary, it's a giant step to being successful in any science class. So here are my tips to learn your vocabulary. Learn how to say it out loud. Write it over and over until you can get the spelling correct. Highlight it in your textbook or in your handout, and then translate it, meaning break it down into its word parts. So saying it out loud, just like you would learn a new language such as Spanish, medical terminology is a language in itself. So you need to be able to practice these words out loud. I recommend saying it out loud to yourself, practice it with your classmates, or even practice it on your family and friends. Write it. You need to make vocabulary lists. Write these terms over and over again so that you can learn how to spell them correctly. I also recommend that as you're writing it, to say that out loud as you're writing it. Another way to practice would to be crossword puzzles, doing any kind of review games, so that you can do a more interesting way of writing these words. Highlight it. If you own your textbook, highlight the word in your textbook so you know that you need to practice that word. Highlight in your notes or in your handouts so that you remember that these are key words to learn. And the last part is translate it. If you can break these words into their word parts, their roots, their prefixes, and their suffixes, it will help you to be more efficient and when you learn new vocabulary. For example, what does a cardiologist do? Most of us already know that a cardiologist helps us with our heart. Well, if you could learn that the root word cardi with slash tells us it's a combining form, so you know cardio means heart, and a logist always means specialist, anytime you saw the prefix cardi, you would know that has something to do with a heart. Anytime you saw the word logist, you would know that means a specialist. So here's three common word parts that we use over and over in anatomy and physiology. Pre is meaning before, hyper means much, and cardio, as you know, means heart. So you could just practice by writing and memorizing, or I like to learn pictures to learn these new words. So here we see some kids, they're jumping on the couch, and we would say they're acting hyper, or they're hyperactive. Hyper means much. So instead of just writing the word, you could remember this picture that tells you hyper means much. And here we have a picture of a premature baby. Pre means before, mature means age. So this baby was born before he was ready, so he's a premature infant. And so what are we looking at here? We're looking at a cardiologist because he is holding a heart. So every time you see heart, you should think cardi.